I'm going to tell you some information you need to know about the real estate market if you are planning on buying a home in 2021. Stay tuned. What's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Brandon Peters. I'm a real estate agent here in the Los Angeles County area. And if you want to learn about the real estate market, make sure to subscribe down below so you never miss a video. So it's no secret the real estate market has been absolutely insane these past 12 months. If you're planning on purchasing a home this year, there's a few things you're gonna wanna know, like what are prices expected to do, what are the average days on market, and what are interest rates expected to be throughout this year. So let's get right into it, guys. National Association of Realtors Chief Economist Lawrence Yun is expecting prices to rise 3% throughout 2021. Realtor.com, Daniel Held's chief economist, is expecting prices to rise 5.7% in 2021, and Zillow expects prices to rise over 10%. I don't really expect over 10% growth to happen. That seems pretty generous to me. But what do they all have in common? All of them are expecting prices to increase throughout 2021, meaning that homes today are cheaper than where they're going to be in 12 months from now. Good thing to keep in mind if you are purchasing a home this year. What are interest rates expected to do in 2021? Well, Freddie Mac put out an article. Current rates are 2.65% for a 30-year fixed loan, and they are expecting interest rates to stay in the high twos and under 3% throughout 2021. Housing inventory right now is at an all-time low. I'm sure you've probably noticed that there's not a lot of homes on the market to choose from at this time. Our average days on market is 21. That plays into the fact that there are not a lot of homes for sale. Now, typically we sit on about 6 months of inventory. Let me explain what that means. If after today, no homes came on the market for sale, it would take buyers roughly 6 months to buy up all the inventory. Around this time last year, we had 4 months worth of inventory, and right now we are sitting a hair above 2 months worth of inventory. That means around this time last year, there was twice as many homes for sale than there is today. So if you're wondering why you can't find a home, keep that in mind, guys. You are not the only one dealing with this problem. This is a problem that a lot of buyers are dealing with. They are not finding any homes for sale. They're not finding any homes that they like. Well, it's not you, it's not your budget, it is the market, guys. We are struggling with inventory right now. They are predicting that the market will be more favorable and we will see more homes coming on the market. Typically, we do see more homes come on the market around February time. You guys also have to keep in mind that we've had three major catalysts in the market. We had the holidays, we have COVID, number one, really, and then we had elections. These are all things that play a factor into the amount of homes that we have on the market. So taking all this in, what would my advice be for someone who is thinking about purchasing a home in 2021? First things first, find yourself a realtor that is active in the market, that's a pro, they do this full time, and they have relationships with other agents in the business. That is definitely something that will be beneficial to you. The other thing would be to find a direct lender. So you go to banks like Chase, Wells Fargo, B of A, they are a little slower right now. Sellers wanna see fast escrows or at least respectful escrows, meaning closing in under 30 days. Chase, B of A, Wells Fargo, big institutions like that, they would have a very tough time meeting that time frame. You go to a direct lender, they will easily be able to make 21 days or 30 days happen for you guys. My other piece of advice is when you are submitting offers, be under the impression that any home you submit on will have multiple offers. So when you are submitting an offer, time is of the essence. If you like this property, get your offer in right away. Sometimes, and it's happened, I've had experiences like this in the past where I submit an offer very strong right up front, and they just take it, even though right after they received better offers, higher prices than mine, but I was fast and I gave them something that was respectful and strong right off the bat. And if you are thinking about purchasing a home this year, buy a home if you are expecting to live in this for at least 5 years. If you are planning to buy a home and sell it within 2 years, I don't know if right now would be the best time to purchase. It would be too short of a time to know kind of what the market's gonna do in the next 2 years, and a little bit riskier than someone who's gonna stay there for a minimum of 5 to maybe 10 years. And at the end of the day, guys, this is about you. You do what you are comfortable with. Do not force yourself to purchase a home if you do not feel like you are ready. I say this to all of my clients, we are never gonna run out of houses for sale. So do not force something, be patient. The right home will come along for you guys. It's only a matter of time. That's it for this video, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Again, if you are interested in learning more about the real estate market, make sure to hit the subscribe down below, and I'll see you next time.